Hi, guess what? Today I've come up with two jugs, say containers. One of them is a 5-liter container and another is a 3-liter. We are going to solve a maths question using these. As per the question, we are required to get 4 liters of water using these two containers. The question here assumes two things. One is that these containers are not calibrated, that is, we can't measure water as such. And another thing is that we have unlimited supply of water, enabling us to fill and throw water whenever we need to. So, how do we do this? Do pause the video to think of the solution. I'll lead you towards the solution now. Before we move on to solution, I would like to tell you that I've used certain representation here. I have used 1 oval to represent 1 liter of water so as to ease the explanation. Now, the very first step here would be to fill the 5-liter container full. Since it's a 5-liter container, it will have 5 liter of water in it now. In second step, we transfer water from 5-liter container to 3-liter container until it's full. That means 3-liter water has been transferred from 5-liter container to 3-liter container, leaving only 2-liter water in it. In third step, we'll throw water in 3-liter container to empty it. In fourth step, we will transfer the remaining water in 5-liter container, that is 2-liter water, to 3-liter container again. Now, the 3-liter container has 2-liter water. For fifth step, we'll fill 5-liter container again. For sixth step, we will transfer water from 5-liter container to 3-liter container until it's full. As the 3-liter container already has 2-liter water in it, it will accommodate only 1 more liter of water. Now, just look at 5-liter container. There is 1, 2, 3, and 4 liters of water in it. And we have solved it. We now know how it is done. But knowing the solution is not sufficient unless we actually have some mechanism to proceed with the solution. What can be the mechanism then? Basically, it's hit and trial method. But how do we know where to hit so as to be able to quickly do it and with less efforts? Let me try to give you at least some inputs to start with. So, we need 4 liters of water. But we do not have a 4-liter container as such. And we can't directly measure it as the containers do not have calibration on them. So, what we can do is, we can try to make certain combinations of numbers of liters in order to predict how to go about it. Some plausible ways we can get 4 are adding 2 and 2, adding 3 and 1, subtracting 1 from 5. Here, the options 5 minus 1 and 3 plus 1 have the possibility of working as we have containers of 3 liter and 5 liter. Let's try with 5 and 1. We do not have any difficulties getting 5 liter of water as we can always empty it and fill it to the full. To get 1 liter seems a bit difficult, but it's not as difficult as it looks. Just think of it. We can actually get 1 liter using 3 liter and 5 liter containers. Think of it. 5 subtracted from 2 times 3 does give 1. This in practical term means we are required to pour 5 liter water in 2 3 liter containers. That is, fill 5 liter container and pour into 3 liter container to fill it. And then throw the water in 3 liter container and pour the remaining 2 liter water again into 3 liter container. This time, the space that's not been filled is 1 liter. What we do now is fill the 5-liter container again and pour into the 3-liter container until it's filled. So, the water in 5-liter container is now 5 minus 1 equals to 4 liters. This is exactly what we did in our solution. We can try with 3 plus 1 method and it will also lead us to solution. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe for more videos.